This five-star hotel wants to send you to the Maldives. I'm lucky. And I think when you're lucky, you have to do something. And I'm doing charity work with Amfire. I found $10 on the street. She said, put some of it in the poor box in the church. It makes you feel so good.
We don't have to have a lot to offer and give to another.
The St. Regis is sending me and Courtney to Aspen.
Okay.
And I know this is a test. You know, I always see everything as a test. And I'm going to give a speech, and I'm also going to do charts for people who want them, guests, you know, and I'll put it on my site because Aspen is not that far from L.A. So, and you know, L.A. is my number one city in the world on my website, and New York is number two, London's number three. But if you take out Europe, Houston's number three, which just burst on the scene. Wow. It came out of nowhere. Houston has become quite a tech center, too. So Houston's number three. So I think some of them may be able to go. And then, oh, one day, you know, we read the reader mail. We read all the mail. Maybe somebody didn't get a book or a calendar. Maybe someone didn't understand something. Maybe somebody saw a mistake I made. We have, and the press writes constantly from every country. So every day at 5 o'clock, Courtney calls me. She said, we got a letter, Susan. This five-star hotel wants to send you to the Maldives. I said, oh, that's really far. She said, we have to go immediately. It's on my bucket list. It's supposed to be the most beautiful place on earth. I said, you really want to go? Okay, ask them if I can bring you, because I really do need you. Because when we went to Crete last year, the hotel wasn't so, it was another five-star hotel. They weren't sure that they needed her. But I said, I need her to keep New York going, you know, and all the letters and everything that comes in. So I said, okay. What I didn't know is how much they loved her behind the scenes. You know how people say, oh, I'll do a 10 o'clock appointment. I'll do an 11. Well, all the guests were changing. I want to go to the leper colony. There's no lepers there anymore. I want to go snorkeling. I want to take a tour. So she was seamlessly, like a gazelle, changing everything. She had a conference call with the people, the PR girls. They got along great. Everybody loved Courtney. And I wasn't allowed to leave the hotel. I got like two and a half hour, you know, chances to see the island, but there were so many guests that were coming in from Serbia, from Turkey, from Ireland, from Spain, all over the place, that, and I didn't want to disappoint anyone. There was a man who was coming in from Serbia, and they said, we don't have a room. I said, come in anyway. Maybe you can find an Airbnb, but we're going to try to get you a room before you get here. And we did get him a room. We never like to say no. And they want me to come back, so we asked, could I see a little bit more of the island and maybe even go across the bay to Santorini? They said, absolutely.
And you're like, the last time I was just in the hotel, and it was a nice hotel. But
one thing I learned, that they have the best tomatoes on the planet in Greece. I couldn't believe how flavorful they were. So so I'm going to the Maldives in the beginning of May, and they said, what kind of view do you want? Like a view that the other guests don't want. I mean, you have to save it for them. She said, no, no, we're going to take care of you, and Courtney's coming. And I love her. She works so hard, and she's so imaginative about what I need. Before I go on a trip, like here, I have a whole folder. I have all the flights on this side because I have to go up to San Francisco on Saturday night and do a talk in Bloomingdale's there.
Yeah.
And I'm doing charity work with Amfar. Do you know that charity?
No.
You know what? I had asked the Red Cross. They're like, no, we don't need you. I'm like, oh, God. You know, I've had 40 blood transfusions in my life. Did you know that if you don't give blood someday, you know, the older people are dying and, you know, natural, but they're not. The older people used to give blood and younger people aren't. And if we don't have enough blood, we have to use pig's blood because it's the closest to human blood. But that bothers me, you know?
Wow. And with all the different blood types, they need the variety, right?
They totally do. And when you're giving blood in the Red Cross, you see Time Warner Cable come in or Verizon. The guys come in, I got an hour here. And they say, okay, oh, you're here again. You know, they know them. And they say, okay, we're going to take you first. We know you have appointments. And so Amphora called me and said, would you like to help AIDS? I said, yes. I've had all these blood transfusions.
You enjoying this so far? Did you forget to subscribe? Make sure to do so. It takes 2 seconds. Just press that little button, the red one. You know the one. Just press it, little like. All right, enjoy the rest of this content.
And, you know, Elizabeth Glaser was the most famous person who died from a blood transfusion. She was part of the DNC. She was in her 9th month of pregnancy. She had 7 blood transfusions. One was contaminated. She died, and I think her daughter in utero. Wow. She died too later, 10 years later. So I'm lucky. And I think when you're lucky, you have to do something. You know, when I was little, I told my teacher, I found $10 on the street. She said, put some of it in the poor box in the church on the way home. And I never forgot that. And I thought that was so nice. It made such an impression on me. And they're so nice. And it makes you feel so good. They said, okay, the first one's in San Francisco. We want you to come. Okay, no problem. The theme is Casino Royale. So, oh, I better brush up. I saw that movie, James Bond, but I better watch it again. So I did. I got a red satin dress off the shoulder, you know, black tie, you know. And so now they said, you have to sit near the fireplace. The fireplace was over there. There was a couch here and a couch here. So I'm sitting here, and I came early, and there's a man in a tux on his phone, and nobody's talking to me yet. So I say, are you James Bond? And he looks a little confused because it's a common name. He said, no, I'm Jonathan. I said, oh, have you seen James? He said, do you think he's coming tonight? I'm like, well, he better, because I flew in from New York and it would be really bad if I didn't get my assignment. He said, oh, I see what you mean. I said, are you in the Foreign Service too? He said, no. He's looking confused. And he said, I'm in fashion. And I go, a great cover. Great cover. And he said, I'm going to come sit next to you. You're fun. And he said, you know what? After talking to me, I'm getting all my friends to come in to bid on you. You know. And we did have the bidding high for $1,000. You know, I said, I really want to help the charity, you know. Yeah. And they said, oh, don't worry. We're hard on our donors. And they laughed, you know. And Gwyneth Paltrow was there, John Hamm. Alan Cummings was supposed to come, but he couldn't make it that night. But I can see why people do philanthropic work. And I always used to think you had to be rich and you know, to do it. But you can do things. You can help people. And this is a charity close to my heart. There are 38 million people that are still suffering in other countries. And they have so many cures now. They're really on top of it. And they still have to do some more research.
Yeah.
And so this is a new thing for me, but I'm enjoying it.
I love it. And we'll put a link down below so that if people want to learn more about that particular charity or donate.
Yeah, it's spelled A-M and then F and then a big A-R because it's American Federation of AIDS Research. That's what it stands for. Yeah. And they're in New York and they're on the West Coast too. They give parties all over the world. And it's really fun watching the bidding on a Thai weekend by the water, $40,000, or go see a Versace runway fashion show. I mean, I was keeping my arms down.
You're like, ah, no, please, please don't bid me because I don't want to actually win it.
I know.
You ever done one of those things where, like, I've been in things where I've been, like, so excited that I've like, really bid high, and then I'm like, please, somebody outbid me.
Yes, yes. And, you know, this was given by Mrs. Getty at her mansion, and all her family was there, her daughters, her granddaughters, her... what a lovely family, and very unpretentious. And I was like, wow, this was really fun. And it was like a painting. It was an old building, and I love old landmark buildings, you know, right in San Francisco. So
that's beautiful. And I love what you said about, you know, you don't have to be rich to mm-hmm. be and give in charity. And even going to that example that you gave when you found the $10, like, okay, so put a couple dollars, you know,
yeah,
like
even, put something even, in the poor box. Yeah. Yes.
And that's like, you know, we don't have to have a lot to offer and give to another. And that it's that joy of giving, you know, and I see that even like in the conversation that we're having, like how much you love making sure that people are taken care of, supported, that, like, I mean, going out of your way to make sure that somebody that's flying in to come see you is making sure that they have a hotel room. I mean, that's like, you know.
Yeah. No, we work on that. Yep. Well, I once.
If you like this content, make sure that you like, subscribe, and comment below. And we also have amazing link right there for some cool product. I know you want to check it out. I know you want to click it. Go ahead. Go ahead. Come on. You can do it. All right, until next time, have a beautiful, blessed day.